Aloha, and welcome to Live at the Legislature. I'm Carolyn Tanaka, and every Tuesday we sit down and talk to members of the House of Representatives about legislation, issues, and concerns moving through the halls of the state capitol. But today we're not going to talk about legislation, we're going to talk about the census. You have heard about it, you have seen about it on TV, we're going to talk some more about it because it is something that is very important to the people of this state. Joining me this morning is Representative Ty Cullen. He represents, here we go, Waipahu, Royal Kunia, Village Park, Westlock.
Yes, portions of Kapolei and Eva. So it's a mouthful.
Right.
I know it is.
And all parts in between. Also with us is Annie Sokol. She is with the U.S. Census Bureau. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me on.
So let's talk about it. The census. We all know the word. Why should we care?
Well, for the state of Hawaii, the census is important because the federal impacts not only affects the state, our communities, but it affects our families. Because, you know, federal funding is very important in how we utilize funding resources throughout our communities, and especially directly to the families that are paying federal taxes. If you're paying income tax, if you're paying gas taxes, you want your fair share. So it is important that you or we get our fair share back from the federal government, because in communities we always complaining that the government is taxing us too much. So this is one of the ways where you can really utilize your count, your number, your family's count to get what is due, because federal highways construction, that money comes back through a formula-based federal government. Population is part of that formula, and we need to receive some of that government money back. Medicare, Medicaid is big areas. Also Pell Grants for students who go for higher education.
Money.
Yeah, scholarship
right.
money. So these are just, you know, general terms, how is important, and direct federal monies that come. 2017, state received directly because of population count over $5.8 billion to the state of Hawaii. That's in 2017. You know, 2020, numbers could be a lot higher.
But one of you, we have not been, Hawaii has not been doing too well on the response rate, right?
Yes, we have not been doing well on the response rate. The national average in 2010, our self-response was 74%. We came in at 68%. So, you know, I hope, like in everything, Hawaii wants to be best. We do it on a lot of the live networks. So maybe Hawaii, we can get to that national average or even higher of going beyond 74%. That's where we are on today, because we want to ensure that Hawaii can really push and break through some of that barrier ceiling, so we can really move forward on getting a, not just a complete, but a very accurate count.
Mm-hmm. So, Annie, tell me, what can people expect? Some deadlines and stuff, process-wise, real quickly.
Thank you. Yes. Actually, in 2 days' time, beginning March 12, households can expect an invitation on the mail to respond to the census. Mm-hmm. So that's from March 12 to 20. It is just a letter. You will be given an instruction on where to go online to respond, and it has a corresponding census ID as well. And then after that, if you haven't responded during that time frame, you will get another reminder, and then a third reminder towards the end of March, early April. Mm-hmm. And then if you are not comfortable doing it online, you still have the paper questionnaire option, which you will receive around April 8 to 16. So if you prefer that mode, please wait for the paper questionnaire to arrive. And then after that, you will get a final postcard. Aside from those two options, you'll still be able to call as well. So we're really encouraging everyone, as Representative Cullen said, self-response is very important. So you have that time frame from March, mid-March to April, to go ahead and register online on paper questionnaire and on the phone. It's very important.
So yes. the U.S. Constitution says that every 10 years we need to count every person in the United States.
Yes, that's correct.
Whether you are...
So, yeah, we count everyone. It's a once-a-decade count. We count everyone in the United States, whether you are a citizen or not, as long as you are a resident of the United States and you live here, you should be counted because, you know, we all benefit from having that accurate and complete count because, again, it's the money that comes into our community. It's our representation in Congress. It's redistricting. So a lot of things are, you know, really... hinges on the census.
So, Representative Cullen, can you give us some examples, practical examples of how the response on the survey impacts everyday working people?
Yes, yes. So, for example, you know, one of the biggest areas of federal funding is, I think, 13% of our Department of Education, where, you know, our students, our families send their kids to our public education institutions. They have, you know, they receive a direct funding, especially with Title I money.
Right.
So, you know, no matter what, families in Hawaii indirectly or directly get impacted. If you are using our highway system, driving on our roads, if you want us to have better roads, this is regarding more federal dollars coming in so we can actually fix some of these roads. Because we do pay a gas tax, a federal gas tax. So we want to make sure that money is not going to some other state. For every undercount that we do, for every one percentage point, it's an estimated $37 million loss. So in that sense, if we undercount, then we're losing money. That means money is going to another state. That's why in the House here, you know, take it up with leadership. They're really pushing the census because, you know, as Vice Chair of Finance, seeing the budget and as we work, we don't want to lose federal money. We want more federal money so we can utilize it and really help out other areas within our state budget so we can really help our communities so that they can benefit from them.
Well, I know that you have taken a, you and Representative Henry Aquino, who also represents the Waipahu area, you both have taken a keen interest in the census. And in fact, in your community, you've got a census event coming up. You want to talk about
yes.
that?
Yes, yes. So we, Representative Aquino and myself, has partnered with the Filipino Complete Count Committee on Oahu, and we are holding a census fair, which is on March 14th, and it is at Waipahu High School Cafeteria. It will be between the hours of 10:30 and 2:30. We have students from the area schools, both intermediate, elementary, and high school, clubs that are will be performing and doing the program so we can bring the families out to the census fair. And that's the driver to get people to get interested, and it's at the school because federal money from the census goes to the schools.
And we're talking about lunch program, breakfast program, all those kinds of things. We've run out of time. This is so fascinating, this census, and you guys have been very informative. Thank you for joining us this morning, and we will talk more about it later, I'm sure.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining us at Live at the Legislature. We will see you next week. Aloha.
What are you doing? We have to go. I'm gonna be late for work.
It's Tuesday morning. I gotta record live at the legislature on Alelo. Senate and House leadership discussing what's happening at the state capitol.
So just watch it on the news tonight. Come on, let's go.
Hey, this is like getting the news before it's news. If only I could get this remote to work.
There. Can we go now?
No DVR? No problem. Watch Wednesday evenings at 7 p.m. on Channel 49.